today I'm going to talk about mouthwashes, the different types that we have, the ones that are good for you, the different types and what they do. Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Venom Duck. I'm always glad to be back here. Alright, so if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do hit the subscribe button down below and give this video a thumbs up if you love what you are seeing or you're about to see. And I'm glad that you're here again with me today. Today, I have some interesting things to talk about. A few people sent in some comments and some topics I should actually talk about. So today, I'm starting off with one of them, and that has to do with mouthwashes. I have a lot of people or a lot of patients asking questions about mouthwashes, which is good, which is better. They get confused sometimes when you go to the drugstore, to the supermarket, and then you go to the aisle where you have mouthwashes, and then you're confused. Like, when you look at the different brands, there are millions of brands out there, like a whole lot of them. You know what? I'm going to help you today, so that you don't get confused when next you go shopping for a mouthwash. So it can be confusing when you have to get mouthwashes. So let me make it simple. I'm going to divide mouthwashes into two major groups, which makes it easier for you. So we have the antiseptics, anti-cavities, the antiseptics are also called antibacterial, okay? Your anti-cavities are also called fluoride rinses. Alright, so let's start with the antiseptics. Now, your antiseptic mouthwashes are good for your gums to control and also to control plaque level. Also, they are good when you have ulcers on your gum, that sores on your gum. Yeah, the antiseptics. Your antiseptics also help to reduce bad breath. Okay, they help to kill bacteria in the mouth that causes bad breath, you know, gingivitis and all of that. So your antiseptic plays a very important role when it comes to that. And one of the things about your antiseptic is that it has a stingy feeling, stingy taste when you put it in your mouth. Like, you know, I don't want to say it's a burning sensation in that sense, it's just like a stingy. Yes, and it's because of some of the content, especially the alcohol content in your antiseptic mouthwashes. I'm still going to talk about alcohol and non-alcohol mouthwashes, alcohol-free mouthwashes. I'll get to that part. Now, for your antiseptics, you use them mostly in the morning, okay? They're best to use in the morning, once you're done brushing your teeth and flossing, then you rinse with your antiseptic mouth rinses or antibacterial mouth rinses. They're most effective in the morning. You can use them at night too, but like I said, it's most effective in the morning. Now, for anti-cavities mouthwashes, which are also called fluoride rinses, okay? They're called fluoride rinses because, of course, the fluoride content in them helps your teeth to be resistant against cavities. Okay, fluoride rinses are particularly good for individuals who are cavity prone. That's individuals who are prone to having tooth decay. Anti-cavity mouthwashes will be very good for you. Also, patients or individuals with braces, anti-cavity mouthwashes are very good for you. Although we have orthodontic mouthwashes, you know, orthodontic mouthwashes, patients that have braces on, you can also get orthodontic mouthwashes, which is very good for your gums and your teeth while your braces treatment is ongoing. With that, now with your fluoride rinses or anti-cavity mouthwashes, it's best to use them at night. Yes, your anti-cavity your anti-cavity mouthwashes are best used at night. Reason because once you brush at night and you floss and you rinse with your mouthwash, you're going straight to bed. So that the effect of the mouthwash is still on your teeth and it does its job while you're asleep and, you know, you're in bed and all. So that's the best time to use your anti-cavity mouthwashes as a fluoride rinses. Now, can you use them in the morning? Sure, you can still use them in the morning. But what you need to do is, once you're done brushing your teeth and flossing, and you use your anti-cavity mouthwashes, you need to wait for 30 minutes before you eat or take any other thing into your mouth. And that's because you're giving yourself 30 minutes, you're giving the mouthwash 30 minutes for it to still have an effect over your teeth. Yes, so if you have to use your anti-cavity mouthwashes in the morning, you have to wait for 30 minutes before you put anything in your mouth. So that's why it's best to just use it at night. You're going to bed anyways, not like, except for people that like to do midnight snacking. Mm-hmm. Of course, if you do your midnight snacking, you have to brush again and use your mouth rinse again and go to bed. So yeah. All right, now I made mention of alcohol and alcohol-free mouthwashes. There's some categories of mouthwashes that I'll just throw some light on. They're called prescription mouthwashes. Prescription in the sense that your doctor, your dentist actually prescribes this because they have a limited amount of days you should use them. They're not mouthwashes you just go buy off the counter and then keep using because they have side effects. If you keep using them for longer than necessary or longer than the time your doctor has prescribed to you, they have contents or ingredients that could actually have side effects if you continue to use them just like your regular mouthwashes. So prescription mouthwashes contain what you call chlorhexidine. So chlorhexidine helps in killing bacteria, making them inactive, especially when it comes to gingivitis and gum disease. Yeah, so your prescription mouthwashes, you have to be careful with them. Follow your doctor's prescription. Whatever your dentist tells you how to use them is what you should, is how you should use them. And then use them for example, there are some that you just have to use for 2 weeks and that's it. 2 weeks, if you use for more than 2 weeks, for some of them you can start to have some discoloration on your teeth. Yeah, some of the prescription mouthwashes you have, enoperoxide, hydrogen peroxide is one of them. You have to be careful with that. The doctor has to prescribe that to you. The dentist has to prescribe that to you, of course. It's not something you just buy at the counter and use. You might be wondering, how do I get to know this is anti-cavity? How do I know this is antiseptic, antibacterial? How do I get to know which exactly is which? It's very simple. Most of them are labeled, actually. If you check the labels of your mouthwashes, they're all labeled antiseptic or anti-cavity. You know, so you just have to look at the labels on them. For example, I'm just going to put up some pictures for you to see. Some of them are actually written antibacterial on them or antiseptic. That way you can tell which is which. For some brands, they actually use colors. They're color coded. Okay, if you, most of the green, most of the mouthwashes that are green in color or blue, they're usually your antiseptics. Most, I didn't say all, most, most of them that are blue or green are most antiseptic. You even have some that are champagne color, you know, goldish and that sort. Yeah, mostly antiseptic, but it's going to be written on them as antiseptic or not. And then for your anti-cavities, most times they are pink in color or purple, but it's going to be written on it actually, so that helps you. And I know that sometimes people want, and if it's alcohol or if it is non-alcohol, it's written there, especially in the ingredients. So in the ingredients, you're going to see disclaimer. I don't know if this is a disclaimer or not, but mouthwashes are not supposed to replace your brushing and your flossing. No. So please do not substitute mouthwashes for toothbrushing and flossing. This is where I say goodbye. But just before you go, don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't, and the bell, and give this video a thumbs up. If you've liked what you've seen, share with your friends and family and loved ones. Until I come your way again next time, I love you.